Hello, ladies and gentlemen, joining us from around the globe. I'm Adam Perry, joined today with my very trusty Andrew Feary. And here we are back at home, Chandler Gilbert Baseball Field, and it's the Yotes versus the Geckos. And unfortunately for the Coyotes, they fell in a drastic defeat yesterday against the Geckos over at their place. And you know, now the Yotes find themselves in an interesting situation where, you know, it's almost a must win for every game throughout throughout the rest of the season if we want to make playoffs. And this ball is lifted into left field, tracking in. It's Amir McGee, and he'll make the grab for the first out of the inning. But, you know, as I was saying, these Yotes, now they find themselves in such a tough spot, and who better to trust on the mound than Alex Karns?
No, absolutely. Karns is a man, and he's been electric in his past couple appearances. He's gone deep into the game, allowing very few runs, and he's just really developed so much as the season's gone on, and he's the perfect man for this situation. When the Coyotes' backs are on the ropes, I want someone like Karns coming out swinging for us.
Yeah, absolutely. Karns, great starter to have on the Yotes. And on the season, he has 45 and a third innings pitched and a pretty good 3.97 ERA. This ball is lifted into left field, tracking over. It's Amir McGee once again, and he's going to make the grab. And, you know, great start to the game so far for Karns. He's been pounding the zone right around it, and he's got himself two quick clean outs. And up to bat for the Gateway Geckos is number 12. He's got a great flow going on, man.
Oh, yeah.
This ball grounded over to second base. It's Devin DeVera. And the throw pulls Easton Bryant off the bag, but Easton puts a tag on. And just like that, the Yotes are now heading into the bottom of the first, where they're looking to get the bats going today.
Take off. Come on, man.
And here we go into the bottom of the first. And on the mound for the Gateway Geckos, it'll be number 17, Noah Olson. And, you know, it's clear that the Geckos are playing no games here today. Noah Olson is the ERA leader for the Gateway Geckos, posting a 1.57 ERA over 23 innings pitched. So, I mean, clearly a decent share of innings, and to have that low of an ERA is staggering, honestly. He's having a great season. And we'll see how he fares against this Yodi offense here today. Up to bat first, it's Ben Hashizaki. And Hosh is going to square a bunt, pull back, and that'll be a ball one on the high heater.
Hosh and J-Mo, a very effective 1-2 punch to start off the Coyotes in their lineup. They've had a lot of success this season, and this is a very important game, so it's very important that they get things going and they set the tone early. Foul tip there from Hosh. So Noah Olson, a pretty big right-handed pitcher for the Geckos.
Yeah,
standing well above 6 feet.
Yeah, definitely. I would. Before we pulled up, I'm going to guess 6'5". What do you got?
Did you already pull it up?
No, no.
All right. I have 6'6".
Okay. Okay, that's a good guess. And this one's in there for a strike.
Watch him be 6'3".
Hold on now.
So Hosh now. Let's see how effective his two-strike approach is. He's a very good put the ball in play type of guy.
Yeah, and in 2-2 counts, this is really where the at-bats are won and lost most of the time, because if not, you go 3-2. And this ball batted hard over to shortstop, and it's going to bounce off him. Hosh is looking to take two with some heads-up base running, and he does. Hashizaki taking advantage of a fielding error from the Gateway shortstop. And wow.
See, that's exactly what I'm talking about, setting the tone. He doesn't do it with an absolute shot to the fence, but he does it by
scorching,
putting in effort,
yeah,
and really trying to maximize the chances for Coyotes to score runs here in this first by applying pressure right out the gate.
And it looks like Andrew Feary got the better of me in the guessing game. He was indeed 6'6".
Oh, dude.
So Noah Olson, the pitcher for the Geckos. This ball is bounced. Great bunt by J-Mo. Ooh, and he's going to be called out at first on the heads-up play by the catcher. And a bit of confusion. A lot of the Yodi fans in the stands are saying he came off the bag. And John Watson is going out to make his case.
Yeah, he's got a good view.
Yeah. See, this is what they always do. You always have to ask the home plate umpire, because he has a direct angle down the first base line, where a lot of the times.
Ooh, quick conversation.
Oh, wow.
Fucked.
And very quick decision-making by the field and home plate umpire will retire J-Mo, and it'll bring up Dante Turgeon.
Oh, yeah. Dante Turgeon batting in the three spot today. Right behind him is Tate Lewis. So they got runner on third, courtesy of the bunt from Jamison Armstrong, getting Hosh over. First pitch to Dante.
Take a good hack at it. And it's caught by the left fielder. The throw to the plate is not going to be in time. Ben Hashizaki tags up and comes in standing on the sack fly from Dante Turgeon. And the Yodis have drawn first blood here in a very must-win game. And
good
up to bat next.
Good job from Dante right there.
Yeah, great job.
So now there's two outs. Tate stepping in the dish, trying to get things started up once again. Coyotes able to strike first. That's always very important.
Yes, that's the tone, really. Now it's for the remainder of the game. until they do, or if they do, the Geckos are going to feel like they're playing catch-up. And sometimes that can get the better of teams. They start to become too aggressive too early and try and do too much rather than just playing fundamental baseball, which the Yotes must do successfully here today if they wish to come out with a win. This ball lined over to second base, and it's going to be an error on the second baseman. Just didn't glove it right. And Tate Lewis records an on base right there, and he'll be subbed out with Seth Moore. Always good to see him on the field.
Absolutely. Seth is actually somewhat a speed demon, so look out for him on the base path to be moving. Now in the box, though.
Oh, man.
It's the Giant Bryant.
The Giant Bryant. And he's going to foul this one straight back. Noah Olson has been doing a pretty good job so far here today. Obviously very early in this one, but we see some pitchers that struggle to make it through a first inning, and Noah Olson seems to be peppering the zone.
Seth with a healthy lead, and he takes off. Oh, little deke from Seth.
Yep. And a well-placed breaking ball from Olson. So we go to an 0-2 count now. Big Bad Bryant in the box. And Olsen's going to pick over to first. Seth is in safely. They're playing Bryant straight away. We'll see what he can do here, battling from 0-2. The pitch. Oof. Bender that missed low. And now the Giant Bryant in a 1-2 count. Maybe gained a little bit of confidence after that one. Seems to be able to see the ball well, and Olsen's going to pick over back to first. Seth is safe once again. I mean, they know, man. They know the threat of Seth Moore over there.
Yeah. I mean, don't always judge a book by its cover. Seth is a little bit of a bigger guy, but, man, he is extremely fast.
Yeah. Really fast.
And he hustles.
That's his thing. He wants that back more than anyone else.
Yeah. So. He's not going to allow someone to just throw him out.
Every play, that kid on first base, Seth Moore, gives 110% effort, and we mean it. If you look at the camera close enough sometimes, you can see just by his facial expression how hard he's trying.
There you go.
Seth's going to take off, and wow, he's got some wheels today, and he's going to take third base. The throw down from the catcher was mishandled, and it ends up in shallow center field. And Seth Moore ends up on third base. Now the Giant Bryant's also in a 3-2 count. So he successfully battled back now. And we come to the payoff pitch here in the bottom of the first with two outs. Two pitch.
Oh.
This ball lifted to right field.
Get down.
And oh, it just looks like Bryant missed that one. Barely. But
barely. That ball is still
caught by the right fielder for the third out of the inning, and the Yotes will pull away in this first inning with a one-run lead. We'll head to the top of the second, where Alex Carnes looks to make another no-run stand. And up to bat for Gateway at number 16. That'll be Raynon Padilla. He fouls this one off now. Finds himself behind in a 1-2 count. And Alex Carnes finding himself in quite the predicament. One out, bases juiced. Here in the top of the second, we'll see how he's able to work out.
Yeah, and we hear the, oh, that's gonna be a pop fly, reachable for Tate, who's unable to get there. So that's gonna be a second life for number 16.
Raynon Padilla.
Yeah,
Raynon Padilla's batting .211 on the season. He's got a jack, one home run on the resume, as well as a triple and four doubles. He can spray it all around. We'll see what he can do here. He takes a high ball on that last pitch, bringing us to 2-2 now. Carnes wheels, deals, 2-2, and it's going to be a ball low and away. And it seems as though this Gateway swarm or horde beginning to form in the dugout. You can hear it, I'm sure, on the broadcast as well. This ball lifted to center field, tracking over as Hashizaki is going to make the grab. And one run will come across for the Geckos. So they'll even this thing up now, tied at one. And all the runners moved over a base, so now runners on third and runners on second. First base is empty, though. And up to bat, it's number 18, James Warren. Warren's batting .247. And we'll see what he's able to do against Carnes here. Grounds this ball over to second base. Dev comes in, fields it cleanly, and the throw over is good. So Carnes will escape a bases-loaded situation with just one run coming across, and the Geckos have equalized. We're all knotted up to one, heading into the bottom of the second.